Hi, it's Chris Simpson from CS Diecast Tuning. I hope you guys are all well. Today I will be reviewing and unboxing this Otto Models Nissan Skyline GTR. This one is the R33 and it's a tuned model by Mines. So let's begin. Let's unbox this model. As always with all Otto models, they come with this foam polystyrene packaging, which is really, really good. It's the best way, so it's good for transit, and they will be in a little plastic bag and wrapping. Just take that off. These again are one of my favorite models, the R33, as along with the R34. I would say these are one of the best Skylines available. There you go, absolutely beautiful R33, amazing. This is the Mines tuned edition, absolutely beautiful with the Mines decals on there. As you can see, starting off, it's proportionally, it looks spot on. Beautiful, beautiful lines on the 33. I think it had more rounded edges a little bit, whereas the 34 had sharper lines. I actually quite like the 33 for its curves on there. That decal could be done better. The decal on the bonnet, you can actually see the decal paper around it. Not brilliant. I think I could have done a better job on those decals. Should have been maybe cut to the shape of the Mines logo, which it isn't. It's really just cut straight. It could have been better. Side decals, all the other decals were fine. Starting at the front, great headlight lenses, your GTR badge in the middle. It hasn't got perforated grills. You can see your fog lights down there, and obviously your lower front spoiler. The wheels are really, really good. They do rotate, and you have the metal, I don't know if you can see that, you have the metal discs and calipers on there, and it's drilled metal discs on there, so it does look really, really good. And I do love the white paintwork with the red and grey striping of the Mines decals on there. It's just such a shame that it doesn't have opening parts. It's my gripe. I wish it had opening parts on this model, but it's absolutely beautiful. Obviously autoart did do these many years ago, and they're extremely expensive and extremely rare. I can't remember the last time I've seen one up for auction or anything. It's a very extremely rare model that would most probably fetch a fairly high price on there. On the back you have the Falcon tire logos on there, and on the number plate obviously you have the Mines number plate there. Lovely rear lenses, metal etched decals, has a carbon fiber rear spoiler, and if you look on the parcel shelf it has the speakers that you would have on the parcel shelf inside there. The interior is well detailed, looking from the outside in, it is well detailed, and wiper blades are just wiper blades. There's really not much to say about them. They are in line with the bonnet, which is a good thing. The mirrors are also done in a carbon fiber finish. On the underside, not much detail, other than you can see the exhaust box, or exhaust system, I should say. This model is number 763 out of 1500. So there's not that many models of them worldwide. Yes. As always, windscreen windows are a little bit soft. I don't know if you can see that, they are flexing. So all windows and side windows, you do have to be extremely careful with those. Nice finish on the rear windows, showing the heating elements on the windows. Obviously, being Mines, it has that deep front spoiler. Again, that's carbon etched. So you've got the spoilers, front and rear carbon, and the mirrors carbon. No doubt it would have some form of carbon interiors as well. So handles are really nicely detailed on there. Right, so that is the Nissan Skyline GTR, the R33 model. How I'd score this model out of 10, apart from the decal on the bonnet, which isn't done really well, all the other decals and everything else is really good. I would, and with the discs, I would score this, drum roll, it's going to be an 8 out of 10. It is a really lovely model, and then it's again, it's a rare model, so 8 out of 10 is a fair score on this. It's not widely available, so they are, if you can get any R33s, I would recommend you get the R33s, because there's not that many about, especially in 1 to 18 scale. Very, very rare. Okay, tell me what you think. Just add your comments in the comments below and give this video a good old thumbs up